Hey, happy Sunday! If you've been liking these Revit quick tip videos, make sure that you hit that thumbs up. And if you haven't already, make sure that you subscribe and turn on the bell so that you get notifications when I post new videos. Now, if you're looking for a better way to learn Revit other than just watching YouTube videos, then I highly recommend checking out my Foundations of Revit course over at thestudentarchitect.com/classes. And there you can see all kinds of information about what the class is about, what I'll be teaching, how I'll be teaching it, and things like that. And if you enroll within the next couple of weeks, then you can take advantage of my early bird sale. So go ahead and check it out, and I hope to see you there. Now, today I'm going to show you a better way to add enlarged plans into your projects. So let's say maybe we want to have an enlarged view of this mudroom here. So maybe you were taught to create a duplicate view of an existing floor plan that you already have in your project. So I'm going to go over to the project browser and we'll find the first floor plan garage and I'll duplicate that view. Sure, I could duplicate with or without detailing. Let's just duplicate for now. And then maybe you go ahead and crop in this view. And I suppose you could call this an enlarged plan if you just go ahead and make this scale larger than the original plan. So sure, we could make this a half inch in there. I guess you could say, sure, you have an enlarged plan, but there's no reference to this view that we just created on this floor plan. So what's a better way that we could do this? Well, luckily there's a tool called a callout. So I'm going to double click to activate this view. And if I go up to view and call out, you can see that I could create a call out this way, or you can see that the keyboard shortcut for callouts is CA. You also see that there's a drop down here, so you can create it by sketch if you have more of an irregular shape to your call out, or you could just put in a simple rectangle. Now, before I create this view, you can also see that you can reference another view. So if you do have a project where you do have a lot of those enlarged plans that were created by duplicating views or something like that and just cropping them, then this is a way that you could get around that by creating a reference to that view on this plan with this kind of a symbolic call out. So that is a kind of backwards way to do this if you did need to. However, we're not going to do that this time. I'm going to uncheck that and we're going to create a new view. So I'll just click in one corner and then you can see it's already automatically creating this rectangular callout view just with two clicks. And now we have this enlarged plan. So what I can do is I can click on the view head here, double click into the view, and you can see this enlarged plan and it's automatically set to be scaled twice as large as the original plan that it was drawn in. And now if I put this view on a sheet, let's create a new sheet here. Now what I can do is you can see the name of this view is first floor plan garage callout. And if we go back to the floor plan, you can see that there's no reference to this view on any sheet because it hasn't been placed on a sheet yet. But if I go to the sheet that we just created and drag that view over to the sheet, so this is the original copy that we made when we duplicated the original floor plan, and then this is the callout. So you can see it says callout next to the view, so we know that that is the callout view. I also recommend, if you have different types of views within your project, to group them under whatever type of view that they are. So instead of just a generic floor plan, then I would call this an enlarged plan. And I'm going to place this on this sheet here. And then when I go to the original floor plan, you can see a reference to where this view is placed within your sheet. So you can see what view number it is as well as what sheet it's on. So that is a better way that you can add enlarged plans into your projects. So I really hope that you found this video helpful. And if you did, please hit that like button. And if you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and subscribe because it really helps out my channel and it lets YouTube know that you like videos like this and they'll show you more of them. And also make sure you turn on the bell so that you get notifications when I post new videos. Again, if you are a beginner and you're just learning Revit, or maybe if you've been using it for a little while but never really learned the proper ways to do things, then I highly recommend checking out my Foundations of Revit course. A lot of people have been finding it useful, and I hope that you will too. I hope you have a great day, and I'll see you next Sunday.